So, everyone, today's topic is types of RCC beam. We have three types of RCC beam. First is singly reinforced beam, second doubly reinforced beam, and third one is singly doubly flanged beam. First, we will discuss about the beam section. This is the cross section of beam. This is the neutral axis and A. We have two parts, upper part and the lower part. The upper part we will call this compression zone in concrete. Compression zone in concrete. And the lower part is tension zone in steel. Okay. The upper part is compression zone in concrete and the lower part is tension zone in steel. First, we will discuss about the singly reinforced beam. In singly reinforced beam, this is the cross section of the beam. This is neutral axis and compression zone and tension zone. This is a steel bar. The steel bar are present at the lower side. So, what's the meaning of singly reinforced beam? The singly reinforced beam means that the tension, in the tension zone, the steel bar are present, not in the compression zone. This is the width of the beam that will be called B. This is overall depth, capital B, and this is effective depth to the top of the compression zone to the middle center of the steel bar that we will call small d, and the small d is called effective depth. Effective depth. From the center of the steel to the bottom of the beam in tension zone, that the distance we will call effective cover. Effective cover. And the second cover is from the bottom of the steel bar to the bottom of the beam in tension zone, that we call clear cover. Clear cover. In this beam, the steel are present in the tension zone, not in the compression zone. That beam we will call singly reinforced beam. This is the overview of singly reinforced beam. Now we will discuss about the doubly reinforced beam. The second one is doubly reinforced beam. In doubly reinforced beam, the steel bars are present both in the zone. This is the neutral axis and A. This is the width of the beam. This is overall depth of the beam. This is effective depth. This is steel bar are present in the tension zone at the center of the steel, and also steel are present in the compression zone. Both sides steel bar are present. That beam we will call it the doubly reinforced beam. Now the third one is singly doubly flanged beam. The third one is singly doubly flanged beam. In singly doubly flanged beam, that type of beam are the combinations of L type type of beam. The structure is look like that. This is L type, T type, L. These type of beams are known as singly, doubly, flanged. Now the next topic is WSM and LSM. In WSM, the full form is working stress method, and the LSM limit state method. Working stress method is generally based on elastic limit. And the limit state method is based on plastic limit. If we draw the stress strain diagram for working stress method, it will look like that. It is stress from here, strain. The material will be start when we apply the load. It will elastic like that. After this, it will deflect. This is the elastic limit. After this, if we draw the stress strain diagram for limit state, stress strain, and the material will start from here when we apply the load. This is the elastic limit. If we apply more load on particular material, it will look like to bend and it will deflect, it will come in the plastic. These are the difference from working stress method and the limit strain method.